I recently heard a Pops concert in my hometown. It's the first one I'd been to, and I went because they were going to play a Leroy Anderson piece, one I'd never heard of, The Dancing Cat. And ordinarily, I kind of worship Leroy Anderson. He was a shameless hookmeister. He could come up with stuff that would go into your head and never leave. But unlike stuff like Yummy, 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 I've Got Love in My Tummy, you didn't mind at all. And you were very happy to have it there. Things like The Trumpeter's Holiday or The Blue Tango, The Typewriter, Syncopated Clock. He couldn't stop, this guy. And he never was held in any esteem by pop players. Or by, you know, really academy-trained players. When in fact, we all loved him, we just didn't admit it. I didn't know any better, I didn't know what the rules were, so, and I still don't. So I want to play a tune that was not written by Leroy Anderson, but by one of his imitators, a Bavarian guy who aspired to the same empire that Leroy kind of built. It was an empire about 2 feet tall, but it was an empire. Bert Camford had much better luck. And has done the same thing. You'll probably recognize this melody. Thank you. called Wonderland by Night. I think it was written about the Reeperbahn in Hamburg, which is, of course, is where the Beatles first started performing regularly, and where they were discovered by the author of that last tune, Bert Kampfer, the imitator of Leroy Anderson, pretender to the throne of unforgettability, to permanent elevator ubiquity. About the only place you hear him anymore, except for those sort of repackaging onslaughts that usually involved Bobby Vinton and somebody else telling you how great this stuff was. They're wrong about the remastering, if I do say so myself. Anyhow, Bert said, you guys, you Beatles, really may have something, and I'd like you to go in the studio and record something for me. Instead of recording the stuff that we know and that they were doing at the time, he had them record My Bonnie Lies Over the Ocean. Now, his instincts were not always in the service of empire, were sometimes in the service of oblivion. Probably the same thing anyhow. This is a tune that I recorded with Dr. John Harris on piano, a real doctor. He'd lost his license to practice medicine. And if you ever wondered why he lost his license, found out why when you played with it. Like a stone on the wall, I can't help but see that another man's love means more to you than the love you stole from me. There's no good in knowing that I was to blame. He's good for you, but let me explain. He's twice the price you already paid. Just wait for the change.